are 5 symphony orchestras in London. Lots of chamber groups, chamber orchestras and quartets. There's a healthy scene.
I love the musicians here. I mean, I'm just constantly amazed at their ability and the depth of the talent.
They all have a fantastic training from the wonderful London colleges, a wonderful tradition, a wonderful discipline of amazing sight reading. I act as a sort of coordinator between the composer and the orchestra and the producer. I put it all together, I find the right people, find the days, simultaneously I do a budget. This session is pretty big, it's 88 musicians, and we're doing 12 sessions. Jerry Goldsmith is somebody we really like working for because he's just the governor, really. He's fantastic.
So everybody except the trumpets, repeat bar 3.
Time is the most expensive thing about recording music. The quicker that we do it, the less expense it is. And they're amazingly fast. As a matter of fact, I sometimes think I schedule too much time.
We have an enlightened union now. And the Enlightened Union has given us the combined use fee, which is what everybody's being paid today, which is basically a buyout for all the media that they require, which is cinema, worldwide television, video, whatever. So there is a fee on the invoice, which is, that is it. There are no residual payments, no special payments.
In the UK, the services of the musicians are being bought out. So, in other words, as they perform on this particular film score, their performance can be included on a soundtrack album for no additional compensation. So if you're in the business of soundtrack albums, as we are, being Time Warner, Warner Brothers, and all these various record companies, it can become a key factor in your decision making.